At my lowest point, I felt like I needed guidance and affirmation for absolutely everything. I didn't really feel like an individual. I felt like I am just clumped together with everybody else. I didn't want to feel that way anymore. I actually grew up with a divorced family. They both have different parenting styles. I think when I was growing up, I felt a little controlled. It was kind of hard bouncing back and forth from one parent to the other and having different lifestyles between the two. Then when I went to college, I stopped being active altogether. It was my first time of feeling actually released. Like, I have the choice to do anything that I want to do now. So I partied hard, and I partied a lot. I would go out with friends Wednesday through Saturday, and we would party so hard. Life kind of felt like a constant hangover on the weekends. I really didn't know, how do you spend a weekend? How do I spend my Friday night and my Saturday night? It was the only thing I knew how to do. I actually had a friend who sat me down the end of my sophomore year and says, you know what, Allie, you gotta kick your own ass right now. You gotta get up and get working or else you're not gonna be here anymore. And so after that, I really got away from a lot of the alcohol, but then I took on more of the food. I was hanging around with like the people who did the exact same things. And so everybody looked the same. So I didn't think I really had a problem. Our reward for doing well, or our reward for studying, our reward for anything was, hey, let's go get some food. And I would eat and I would eat and I would eat. And it's kind of sad because we would make jokes about how, oh, I'm gonna eat an entire buffet. Oh, I can eat all of that. And then you do, even though you're not even hungry, but you make a joke out of it. I moved away from college and I didn't know anybody, so I was like, oh, I have to live by myself. I have to develop these habits all by myself. I don't have anybody to follow. I don't have somebody to like say copycat or mimic. Everything is literally my choice. And eventually I was like, I am making this choice on Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday to go to McDonald's and get a double cheeseburger meal and a McChicken and a McFlurry and a huge thing of Coke. Why am I making these choices? I knew I needed to make a change 10 times, at least 10 times minimum. And the last time I was like, I'm gonna just throw my whole heart into it. And it took being by myself and taking a huge like personal look at myself and real self-awareness of saying, you know, Allie, this is not who you are supposed to be. And it really clicked one day. I was at home visiting my mom with my dog, and she took a picture of me and put it on Facebook. I had the notification from Facebook, like, oh, you've been tagged in a photo. And I went to go look at it, and I had this pile of emotions that came up. I was so angry that she put this on Facebook, and I can't believe I was so mad because she's just my mom. She wants to, you know, she loves me regardless of what shape I'm in. I told her she needs to take it down immediately, and I don't want to have it on there anymore. And it's so embarrassing to even admit that. Is you're so embarrassed about yourself that you don't want your family to have pictures of you. It's just all the emotions from this slowly developing self-awareness of that you're not happy and you're not the person who you want to be. Then I was like, this is when I need to make a change. I need to do something different. The transition took a lot of alone time for me to evaluate what am I doing now that is not making me happy, and then slowly replacing those things with something new. I owe my dog everything. And when we moved in by myself, it was just him and I, and we didn't have a backyard. So I would take him on walks, and then slowly I was like, you know what, let's go running. You're still a puppy. Let's get this out of you. And then I really started to enjoy it. I wanted to build my self-confidence by myself first and then put myself in the gym. I was very scared to go into a gym, and I was always thinking about, what is everybody thinking about me? Does everybody think I'm this fat chick who is trying to go on a treadmill next to this tiny girl? It's an emotional process. It's an emotional process to talk to yourself and say, hey, I'm gonna go to the gym today. When I first started, it was hard for me to ask somebody. So I want to try doing something. What do you suggest doing? because it was so overwhelming at that point. I had to tell myself is, although somebody might be looking at me or somebody might be thinking something about me, it's none of my business. And in the off chance that they are thinking something negative about me, that's their own problem. And they have a lot more things to work on than just their body. Last year in January, I joined the Bodybuilding.com 250K challenge, and it was perfect. It ended right before my RKC course. I just gave it my all, threw my whole heart into both things, and they both worked out perfectly. If I can weigh 225 pounds and today weigh 153, somebody else can work their butt off just as much to have similar results. You can change to be the person who you want to be. Live each day as if you are already that person.